Hi students, welcome to the next video in Module 2. In this video, we are going to see about the control statements in Java. So in the last video and all, we have seen about the operators concepts in Java concepts. So let us move to the topic. Control statements in Java is divided into three categories. One is selection category, second iteration and jump. That means that selection statement, iteration statements and jump statements. The selection statement, what is the nature and work of this selection statements are? It allows your program to choose a different paths of execution, right? So it will choose, say for example, if condition, if then else, and go to these kind of conditions and these kind of statements are coming under this selection statement. And iteration will enable the executions to repeat one or more times. Right, how many times it's specified in the iteration, that much time this program execution will be repeated. Then jump statement allows you to program to the execute in a non-linear fashion. That break and continue statements are the best examples for jump statement. Likewise, the Java supports three categories of control statements. Those are called as selection statement, iteration statement and jump statement. So selection statement, as we know that if statement, nested if then if else if, laid up statement, switch statement and nested switch statements are the five important different types and different possible types of selection statement. Let us go to the one statements one by one. We know that the general syntax of if will be having one condition. If the condition is true, then statement 1 will be executed, or else the statement 2 will be executed, right? So it find out the boolean value. The condition is true, it the immediate statement will be executed, or else the second statement, what is given in else part, will be executed. So this is what the general format of if. So we'll have one example here, like int a comma b is a 2 integer variable. If a is less than b, means a will be assigned as 0, or else b will be assigned as 0. That means that if the condition is true, a equal to true, or else b equal to 0. Nested if. So more than one if statements are allowed. If the is statement is written inside than another if statement is called as nested if, that is target of another if or else, right? So here we will have one example here. If I equal to 10, when I is the value of I is equal to 10, means at that time when that I equal to 10, it will get into the another if condition of j should be less than or equal to less than 20. So j should be less than 20. So that is the another one condition. So after that, if the condition is true, a equal to b, or else if k is greater than 100, c equal to 0. See, likewise, the if conditions are if conditions are specified inside another if condition. So this is called as if nested if. Another type is if else later. So what is the if else later? Means the general format is if condition is given, statement 1, else if the another one condition. If the condition is also not true, and again in one more else if condition is given. So likewise, it will be followed in ladder way. Then switched statement. Switch statement is another one important way. We know that switch will be having one expression. So based on the expressions, its value, case value 1 means some set of sequence of statements will be executed. After that, break statement will be there. Similarly, value for the value 2, another set of sequence of statements will be written. Break will be there. At the end of each case, the break will be there. Default statement is, default one keyword is there. So if the expression is not meeting any of the case values, the default value statement will be executed. So this is an example of sample switch. Here in the void main, int I equal to 0, I is less than or equal to 6, and I plus plus in the for loop, switch value of switch is given. So it will go up to from case 0, 1, 2, 3. And if the for the last case, that means if the value of I equal to 4, means it will not be satisfied. So at that time, what will happen? The default statement will be written. So that is what it is given here. I equal to 0 will be printed. I is 1 will be printed. I is 2 and I is 3 and then I is 4. IS3 up to IS3 is written. So then when IE value equal to 4, at that time it will not be printed. So it will go to the default one as greater than 3. Likewise, it will execute. Iteration statements. Iteration statements are coming under the categories of for loop, while loop, and do while loop. What is mean by while loop? While loop is the most fundamental loop statement. So this is the syntax of a while loop. That means while it has the conditions and body of the loop, and it will end with curly braces. So here we will see one example. While n equal to 10 is assigned. So what happened? While n equal to greater than 0, up to greater than 0, then what happens? The tick values, that how many times the values will be loops will be executed, like with this tick value it is given. So at that time what happened? N equal to 10, so it will start from 10. Then after the printing it will be decremented by 1. So from 10 to 9 it will be decremented, from up to 8, then till up to 1 it will be decremented. After that what happens? This condition will not be true, so this statement will not be executed. It will exit from the while loop, then it will go and execute the second statement. So second statement is nothing but the closing of void main. So it will come to the end of the void main. Then do while. Do while, what is the new basic nature of do while means? In the do while loop, first executes the body of the loop, then evaluates, right? So the body of the loop will be executed, then the condition is checked. Then for loop. For loop is having the format of first initialization, condition, and iteration. Right, so here we will see how for loop is written. First int n equal to declared here, n equal to, then initialized value is 10, then condition is n is greater than 0, n minus 1 is the increment or decrement part. So this is the one way of initializing the control variable. What is mean by control variable means the n is equal to control variable here, and we can define the control variable inside the for loop also. Here instead of using the, instead of separately increment declaring the n variable, here we can declare in n variable inside the for loop as int n equal to 10, n is greater than or equal to 0, and n minus 1. Likewise we can use. And coming on to iteration part, iteration over a multi-dimensional array is very important one, because in the iteration the next element will be a next array, not a individual elements, right? So this is what the very important one. We will see one example with two-dimensional array. Here n to nums of two-dimensional array with a row size of 3 and 5 is given. According to the two for loops, the values of i plus 1 and j plus 1 will be incremented. Likewise, the values are starting from values equal to 1 to up to value 10. It will be executed. Then break and go to statements are the jump statements. So Java does not have a go to statement, but in some places go to statement is valuable. So it will have a break statement. So what is the basic syntax of break means? Break is having the label. So here a label is the name of the label that identifies the block of code. So what is the block of code written in this label will be identified. So it will go to that label, or else it will break the execution. Then using continue. Continue is another one statement. It performs in, it will be performed in either while loop or do while loop. The continue statements, what it will happen means, it will execute that particular state of statements for this conditions. Say for example, here programming constraint is given, like class name is continue, then it has the for loop and system.out.println of I value. So according to this case, I plus is equal to 1, so it is given here, and modulo operator is given. So modulo operator of given after that continue will be stating. So what happens? It will continue the rest of the remaining program. Then this is what called as continue statement. I hope so your this video is understandable to everyone. I'll catch you in the next video about next topic. Thank you.